Hello, this is Chef John from foodwishes.com with how to do those cool grill marks. By the way, pardon my voice, I just flew in from New York City last night, long trip, so I'm a little hoarse, and boy, are my arms tired. All right, here we go. How to make grill marks so easy. It works with any kind of meat. Now, what you need to do is use a method called 10 and 2. I'm going to pick that pointy end of the chicken breast, and I'm going to have that pointed towards where 10 o'clock would be on a clock face. After a few minutes, I'm going to turn it so the pointy end is now sort of pointing towards 2 o'clock. That's the old 10 and 2 method, and when you turn that over, you're going to get those beautiful diagonal diamond-shaped lines that everybody loves, especially magazine editors, because every grilled piece of meat on the cover has those. By the way, proven fact, diagonal lines look better than straight lines. So if you're wondering why doesn't he do 12 and 3, that's why. It works with any kind of meat. The steak did not have a pointy end like the chicken breast, but I just picked out that corner right there. That works. So going towards 10, then going towards 2, and when you flip it over, you're like, hey, where's the other marks? It doesn't work as well on red meat. So the darker the meat, the less you're going to see the crosshatch, unless your grill is like super hot. But for light meats like chicken, fish, pork chops, works fantastic. Give it a try. So easy. I wanted to get that ready for Memorial Day barbecues, even though I flew all night. That's how much I love you guys. Have a great long holiday weekend. I hope all your food's delicious. And as always, enjoy.